folks, we try again. You think you've got everything set up, only to discover that the battery on the camera was dead. Idea where we're going today. I just took a different road. I know roughly which direction it's taken me. Got a gravel up the road here. I suppose it's to be expected. Not a very great corner for seeing round that one. So I've had this bike now a couple of weeks. Haven't taken either of the other two out since I got this one. I really quite enjoy it. Haven't taken it off road yet, and we'll find a suitable place for that sometime. Slightly on the tall side, I don't know if it's any a bit shorter with the heated seats or not. The previous owner did fit the what they call the ergo seat, which is slightly lower, and the dealer was supposed to supply that to me, but unfortunately the salesman that was involved in the sale wasn't there the day that the bike was being delivered. So he said he'll post it out. There's actually two seats, the original seat, the ergo seat, and this bike is fitted with the lower mudguard from the Adventure S, as they call it. I should think a wave, eh? The same Honda go, they're way on the wrong side of the road there. Of course we came this way in the opposite direction the other day. If we turn this camera we might get a view over this, oh I don't know. camera's high enough to see over the bridge there. The higher you have it, the more you have to spend levering it back into place. It doesn't have to catch the wind, especially when you've got a broadside. I prefer to do it that way though for the stitch fly. You have it at another angle or whatever, the stitch line can be just where you don't want it. Taking that road. No, I could have put taking that one. Turn around. Suspension, I adjusted it, but it's diving a little bit at the front on the front brake. The front brake is quite... Oh heavens, where am I here? Right. Loving the bike so far. The gearbox is quite sensitive, and I've bought these new adventure boots because I've got a thick sole on them so I can get more of my foot on the ground, which is quite important when you're carrying a pillion. You need to keep your bike stable. That's a lovely old bridge. The problem with the boots is that they're pretty thick. There's not a lot of feeling in them compared to my sports bike boots. With the quick shifter, if you happen to touch the gear lever either up or down the toe of your boot or the sole of it while you're riding, it will change gear for you. Maybe try it when I'm on more than just the sports boots, just to get a better feel. I suppose I'm just a little bit of getting used to. The Almond, Perth. Let's go this way. bushes down there. A bit stagnant looking, that pond. Had a dog with him, but he doesn't, just a pair of binoculars. Potato farm there. Yeah, that's a farm track. Day when we were out, we got one of these sort of farm utility vehicles, the type they use for deer stalking, being driven by a young lad who probably wasn't much more than 9 years old. It's one thing them driving these things around their father's farm, but it's a bit silly really to be allowing them to take it on an open road. If they have an accident, there's no insurance. Very little liability if you're only 9 years old. I guess the father would have to take it. Folks, I don't know this road at all, but we're going to look at that for scenery. I love the spot, that bungalow. As they go under this old policy, looks like it might be kale or something. Towards the hills of it. was the right road here, folks. Stunning view all around. To do this road again, get to know the corners, whether it never pays you to get too familiar, because there's a little Glen Shee, I've been there before. We'll head towards the hills here, over here entrance. We need to raise this camber up a bit, see over the hedge and the verge of the road. Let's just follow this one and see where it goes then, I guess. Worth a try, folks. So we're getting a look at this one, going in the opposite direction earlier than I expected. I suppose it'll save me having to turn this view on this camera around. I can both directions quite close together. Is that the one I came from? See what these signs say. Little Glen Sea, Perth. Let's head this direction, see where it takes us. picture up there in the ruin. Well overgrown. Change our mind and go that way. Good size too.